not for you.
All right, guys, so tomorrow, Steph's book launches on Amazon, The Next You. So to congratulate her, she's in the shower right now. Ryder's trying to get these. Tiff's Treats, if you ever had Tiff's Treats, warm cookies delivered to your door, got these for Steph. So we have 6 chocolate chip, we have 6 snickerdoodle. Yeah, they smell pretty good, don't they? They probably smell really good. You probably want all of them. And then some fresh 2% milk, a little bit of ice cream. Let's go surprise her. Ryder, come on, dude.
There's no one outside waiting for you, I promise you.
Yeah, I know, it's Jordan and
I. Come on.
I see a white and blue bus.
All right, congratulations. What? We have a little present for you. In celebration of the book launch tomorrow.
That's my kind of surprise.
Congratulations.
Thanks, baby.
What do you say, Rye?
Is this from you?
This is for me.
Thank you.
We got cookies, we got milk, we got ice cream.
Ice cream? Tiff's Treats. They really prioritizing things during this quarantine.
You know, with all this running that I've been doing throughout this marathon prep, I go through a lot of laundry. I sweat through a lot of shorts. I sweat through a lot of socks. And I will tell you, this is not sponsored by any means, but Features socks, I've talked about them before. They're my favorite socks to run in. F-E-E-T-U-R-E-S. Features. They're great. But I need like a million more pairs because I lose some and I burn through pairs like wildfire during the week on all these runs.
So tomorrow's workout, we have 2.5-mile warm-up and 800 or 400-meter intervals.
What I was saying was tomorrow's workout, according to my coach, 2.5-mile warm-up, and then I have 400-meter intervals. I have 8 of those at a 136 rep, so that's a 6:26 minute per mile pace, and then a 2.5-mile cool-down. So we'll see you guys in the morning. So, some pretty exciting news for today. I figured a great intro for this scene would be getting into the Can-Am in the garage, which is not at the warehouse anymore. We just launched the Embrace to Suck training platform within the Bayer Performance Nutrition app. And the reason we launched it now, it was supposed to be this summer, like I talked about, I think it was my last video. We were supposed to launch the Embrace to Suck training platform this summer coming up. However, with gyms closing and training facilities closing, we wanted to offer some sort of solution so you guys can keep training and maintain your level of fitness. So we're doing this for free for the time being. If you go to the Bayer Performance Nutrition app and you download it, and at the bottom of the app, there's this little icon that says ETS for Embrace the Suck. Click that, go through the checkout process, and it will give you the program for free. You still have to enter your credit card information, but it's free. And you can follow along with the training that we are providing on a weekly basis for as long as this gym training facility closing thing is ongoing because of the coronavirus. So if you want to train with us and you want to train for free, download the app, enter Embrace the Suck training. You have nothing to lose. It's pretty awesome. The team worked really hard to put this together, so it's pretty sweet. The best way to start your morning is with one scoop of In Focus right to the face. So we got the team working behind me. We're gonna do some blue snow cone, like so.
Oh, oh.
Mmm, that's good.
Give me the quote of the day.
Stay consistent. That's all I got for you. It's simple. It's just come to work every day and just do your thing.
Give me the quote of the day.
Dude, I knew you were gonna ask that question, and I still couldn't come up with anything at that time. I was trying to be funny. Ask Jordan first. Come back to me. Come back to me.
Give me the quote of the day.
If it were that easy, everyone would do it.
All right, I like that.
Mike Bear.
I like that.
The famous Mike Bear, the legend.
Second place is the first loser. We're number one, baby.
That's what I'm talking about.
Number one.
Fire!
Yeah, I stole that though. I stole that from somebody.
George, give me the quote of the day.
The quote of the day is, I'm going the distance.
And here's my quote for you guys. As always, go one more. I'll tell you one thing. This is like the first day we've seen a beautiful sunny day for like probably 3 weeks. It's been gloomy. This is absolutely amazing and beautiful outside. Like, this feels like Texas spring. So this morning has been, it's been wild to say the least. We launched the Embrace the Suck training app within the Bear Performance Nutrition app. And like I said, it's free, but when we launched it, we sent out the notification. There were like 9,000 people on the app at once, and it pretty much crashed. And it's been a headache all morning. But we finally got everything back up, working with developers, implementing systems, making some changes. But it's back up and running, and people are running the programs already. So I'm about to hit one of those workouts this evening or this afternoon. I'm gonna hit the first workout of the training program. You adapt and you overcome. We launched. You anticipate there to be setbacks or some sort of road bumps. We hit them, the whole team adapted, overcame, super proud of the whole team and everyone that was a part of it. Joe on customer service was just killing it, so we're good. We're back up and running, we're solid. So a few things. All right, one, tomorrow morning, 10 a.m. Central Standard Time, we launch a new flavor of Flight. This is pink lemonade. So on March 25th, this flavor goes live. I just took this. I'm about to hit the Embrace Suck training home training day one, week one. Now, this company, Free Sleeve, sent me these, a bunch of these free sleeves, and we've been keeping them here at the warehouse, and the whole team's been using them. These things are game-changing, right? So previously, if I ever had to use any sort of ice, I actually would just like grab peas or corn or whatever Steph had in the freezer. And like when I had my IT band issue, I had a lot of pain in the outside of my knee. So I'd have like a bag of peas or like corn on my knee when my IT band was very, like really flaring up. So then Free Sleeve sent me these things. These are absolutely legit. So it's essentially like a knee sleeve you would use for squatting, right? And you keep them in these bags and you keep them in the freezer. They have them for the knees, they have them for the elbows. And I don't have to use peas or corn or carrots or anything anymore. So I just keep these in the freezer. And then when I need them, like after like really long runs, I'll just throw them on my knees. If something's bothering me, you throw it on, I'll leave it on, and it feels absolutely amazing. And they last maybe like, you know, the cold lasts 15 minutes. And then after they're done, I'll throw them back in the freezer. But I highly recommend these, especially for high volume training, endurance training specifically. I will have a link in the description of this video if you guys are interested in checking out the Free Sleeve. I love them. So now let's go through this workout. We only have 3 minutes. 4, 3, 2, 1. Entering Embrace the Suck, home training, week one, day one, exercise one. So let me give you an overview of this workout today. First, we have a push-up tree. Then we're doing planks. Then we're doing shoulder push-ups, core pulse-ups. And then this program calls for a 2 mile moderate paced run. However, I have to do my run that I'm doing for marathon prep. So it's the 2.5 mile warm up, the 400 meter intervals, then closing out with 2.5 mile cool down, I believe. I'll check that before I get into it. But going into this workout, the push-up tree. So this is three different variations of push-ups, right? So each set is three different variations of push-ups. And each set starts at 10 reps. So let me give you an example. Set one is going to be 10 shoulder width push-ups, 10 diamond push-ups, 10 wide width push-ups. And you take a break, you rest for 1 minute. And then you do 9 reps of each. Take a minute break, then you do 8 reps of each, minute break, 7 reps of each, all the way down to 1 rep. So we're doing the push-up tree, all right? So we'll start at 10 reps of each variation. We'll do normal, then diamond, then wide. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Right in a diamond. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And wide. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Minute break, and then 9 of each. All right, that was 2. We're gonna go right into 1. Don't need no break. 1. 1. And last one. We'll do 1 more. There we go. A few more. All right. So I was telling Jordan, like, these home workouts, these bodyweight workouts, takes me back to like when we used to go to the field in the military, like in the Army, and we'd be in the field for weeks at a time or months at a time. You didn't have access to a gym, so like at night, when we were done training, me and my platoon would get in a circle. We'd do push-ups, we'd do pull-ups off of like stairs, the Bradleys, or trees. And we'd do sit-ups, we would do runs, like field training, field exercise was like a shit ton of push-ups, shit ton of pull-ups. And if anyone's ever been to air assault school, I was telling Jordan just now, like overhead arm claps, like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Air assault school, you do like an hour of those where your arms and shoulders are just on fire, but you can kick your own ass without a gym. It's pretty easy. Just do a lot of repetitions of push-ups, pull-ups, bodyweight squats, pulse-ups, all these things we're doing in this program. It's gonna hurt, you're gonna get a workout. You don't always need a gym to get a solid training session. All right, so planks is gonna be, it's 4 sets of planks. The first 3 sets are 60 seconds, 30 seconds rest in between. The last one is as long as possible. All right, so 60 seconds on, 30 seconds off. Keep that core tight. Think about planks. No one wants a sloppy plank. Don't have a sloppy plank. Keep that core tight, back straight. 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest for 30 seconds. We're gonna hit 3 minutes. 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, 3 minutes. Woo! Sometimes you underrate the plank. Shoulder push-up, 10 to 15 reps, 4 sets, 45 seconds rest in between each set. So you can do handstand push-ups. Handstand push-ups are a little harder, but you really just need to elevate your feet. We'll do them here. Last up, do some more core. And this core movement is the pulse up. 20 reps, 3 sets, 30 seconds rest in between. Also, in this app, I don't know if you can see this, we have videos on how to perform the movements. So if you don't understand how to do it or know how to do it, we got you covered. We got these nice little videos that were actually done right in the spot right here. All right, so check it out. The pulse up. Now you're gonna need some core stabilization here. The modified, you can keep your hands back here. You can bring your legs up. All right, that's modified. However, the goal is control the core. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's set number 1.
We're taking short shorts to a next level. Hell yeah. Hell yeah, brother. All right, so we got 2.5 mile warm up and then 8 400 meter intervals and then another 2.5 mile cool down. It is freaking beautiful out. It is perfect out right now. So Jordan's on the boosted board. Let's go warm up, why don't we? So George and Joe are joining me. 8 intervals, 400 meters each, 136 per rep. That's a 626 minute per mile pace with 90 seconds of walking recovery in between. Coach's orders. So here we go, and then followed by a 2.5 mile cool down run.
All right,
set, go.
Is George going?
Oh god.
So we got a collegiate sprinter here. Tell us a little bit about your history.
Where did you go to college?
Once upon a time.
Where'd you go to college?
DePaul University.
DePaul.
With a W. Oftentimes confused for DePaul with an L in Chicago.
George was he was a sprinter in college.
Once upon a time I ran some track and field. My event was the 400 hurdles and the 60 meter hurdles. I mean, how you train for a 400? Do lots of 400s. You gotta get good at pacing. You gotta get good at running very efficiently. It's really all about being relaxed, but as you know, high energy, high output as possible while staying loose. So,
what's your best time?
Let's see, the 400 hurdles, I think my best time is 54.9. I think I just barely broke that senior year. And best in the 400 open was like 51. Never quite broke 50, but again, it wasn't my event. The 60 hurdles was what I was most proud of, and that's what I had the record in, so.
A wild John appears.
Iron John.
Iron John Byers.
Ready for one? I'm just doing one of these.
Iron John coming out with a win there. Showing the young bucks what's up.
Sounded good.
All right, baby.
That's 8 intervals. Last one was 119. About to do a 2.5 mile cool down run. That's a workout. That's the video. Thanks for watching.
Go one more.